Today, we're going to talk about using letters to stand for numbers. And let's begin with an example. 3 times 5 plus 4 equals 19. Here, we just did a calculation. What I'd like to do is turn this calculation into a puzzle. What if instead of 3 times 5 plus 4 is 19, I asked the question, 3 times what number plus 4 equals 19? Now, you already know the answer to this puzzle. You know it's 5 because we did that calculation to start. But what if you asked this to someone? You went up to someone on the street and said, 3 times what number plus 4 equals 19? They wouldn't know off the top of their head. They'd have to think about it a little bit. And that's one of the things you'll learn how to do in algebra. In algebra, though, when writing this down, we don't want to use a question mark to stand for an unknown number. There's several reasons for this. One is that oftentimes you're dealing with puzzles where there's more than one thing you don't know, and there's only one question mark. And so instead, what we do is we use letters. In this example, let's use the letter U to stand for the unknown number. That gives us 3 times U plus 4 equals 19. Now, if we're going to use letters to stand for numbers, we have one little thing we need to worry about. If you look at the 3 times U, the multiplication symbol looks like a tiny little X. Since we're using letters now, we want to avoid any confusion. So instead of the little X for multiplication, in algebra you usually use a dot. So here we have what we call an equation. It's a math puzzle, and it says 3 times some number plus 4 equals 19, and we're using a letter to stand for that some number. You can use any letter you want. The most common one is X. Here we're using U, that's fine. And we call the letter U a variable. This is the algebra term for a letter that stands for an unknown number. So this is one place in algebra where you will use letters to stand for numbers. Here we have a math puzzle, which we call an equation because there's an equal sign. And there's an unknown number, and we're using a letter U to stand for that. And that letter is called a variable. But there are other places in algebra where we use letters to stand for numbers in a different way. Let's see now. Let's imagine that there are two people standing in a room. The person on the left has an idea. And whenever you have an idea, a candle appears above your head. And the moment a candle appears, light shoots out in all directions. So light will shoot out from this candle across the room and into the eyes of the person standing on the right. Now, light moves very quickly. It moves at the speed of 299,792,458 meters per second. That's so fast that for a long time people thought light moved instantaneously, but it doesn't. It just moves extremely quickly. Now, this number, the speed of light, is used so often in both astronomy and physics that rather than writing the number over and over again, it saves time. It's really convenient to use a letter to stand for this number. And the letter that we use is C. And here, we're using the letter C to stand for a number, but we do not call it a variable. We call it something different. We call it a constant. And this is because we know what the number is. Previously, we had an equation where we did not know what the number was. That's why we call it a variable. Here, we do know what the number is. We do know the speed of light. And because we know what it is, its value never changes, we call it a constant. Let's see another example in another way that letters are used in algebra. Suppose we have a circle. The distance around a circle is called the circumference, and the distance across the circle is called the diameter. Now, for any circle, no matter how big or how small, if you take the circumference and divide it by the diameter, you always get the same number, 3.14159. The number does continue, but this is a very good approximation. This number from geometry is so common in all areas of math and science that it has a name. Its name was given to it hundreds of years ago, and that is pi. Now, this is also a letter. It's just not a letter of the English alphabet. It's a letter of the Greek alphabet. And the reason pi is chosen, it was chosen a long time ago, and it was the first letter of the word parametros, which means perimeter. And since it deals with the perimeter of a circle, you know, that's kind of what inspired this choice. But it's so common and so useful. Rather than always having to write 3.14 or 3.14159, etc., you can just write the Greek letter pi. And to demonstrate how much of a time saver it is to use letters to stand for numbers, let me write down the formula for the area of a circle, once using words and no symbols, and the other using letters. The area of a circle is pi times the radius squared. But if we use letters to stand for all parts of this formula, we can save ourselves a whole lot of writing. Instead of the word area, let's just use the letter A. And instead of the number 3.14159, let's use the Greek letter pi. And instead of the word radius, let's use the letter r. And don't forget, exponents are a way to write down repeated multiplication. So instead of pi times r, we can simply write down the area is pi times r squared. And in this formula, the letter r is a variable, the letter a is a variable, and the Greek letter pi is a constant, because this value, 3.14159, never varies. It's always the same, just like the speed of light. So here are three different places where letters are used in algebra. As a variable in an equation, which is a math puzzle, and one of the things you'll learn to do in algebra is to find out what is the value of that variable. We can also use letters to stand for constants, numbers that never change. And as we saw from astronomy and physics, we use the letter C to stand for the speed of light. And in fact, for most numbers that don't change that are commonly used in math and science, there's usually a letter to stand for that. And this letter we call a constant. And the letter doesn't have to be a letter from the English alphabet. Very commonly, we use letters from the Greek alphabet. That's because these letters were often chosen hundreds of years ago. And back in that time, it was very common for people to study both Greek and Latin. And so to avoid confusion, they would often use letters from the Greek alphabet. So here are several ways that letters are used as numbers in algebra.